In the last two videos, first we talked about the if function and then the and or function. Well, actually, when you're using functions in Excel, you'll see that the and function, the or function will just give you a result true or false. Most of the times when you're working on Excel, you would want the true and false to actually result in answer C or D. And for all such cases, you'll have to use the and or formula in conjunction with the if formula. Let's now look at some examples to explain it further. Now here's an example where we're saying that boarding pass for a domestic flight can be issued to you only if you have a driving license, a government issued identity card, or a passport. Now let's say this is your data for Mr. X, Y, and Z, and then you need to actually select whether it's a yes or a no for any of these documents. And now we want to put the if formula along with the or formula. So it's going to be equal to if bracket start and then use the or function. And within or function, the first condition will be whether the driving license is available or not. So you put it equal to yes, comma, ID card, yes, comma, passport equal to yes, brackets close. So now your or function is closed and you want to give the true or false for the if function, comma. If this value is true, then you say yes, that you want to give this person a boarding pass. If not, then say no, brackets close. Enter. I'm not just copying and pasting the formula in the below cells using the control D function that we already know. Now that the formula is ready, we just need to add a yes to any of the documents that is available. And since this is an OR function, so any one condition is satisfied and we get a yes answer. Let's say here we put a yes, it's a yes here, we put a yes here, this also becomes yes. We put a yes here, this also becomes a yes. Now let's look at another example where we're using the if formula with the and formula. Let's change the earlier example a bit and say that, okay, now you need all the three documents to get a boarding pass. In that case, you will need the and condition in conjunction with the if function. So now let's use the and function with if function here, and the formula will be equal to if bracket start and bracket start, the first logic equal to yes, comma, the second one equal to yes, comma, the third one equal to yes. So yes, brackets close. And if this condition is satisfied, you will say yes, or else it will be a no, brackets close. And then let's just copy this formula on all the three cells. Let's now try and test this formula. Here we see that if we put the TL equal to yes, still the answer is no. And then we put the ID card yes, still the answer is no. Only when you put the passport as yes, you'll see that the answer becomes yes. Similarly here, you'll see that the answer becomes yes only when all the three conditions have been satisfied. When you're actually using Excel, you will see that you'll quite often use if formula in conjunction with the and or formula, and the nesting will keep increasing and things become easier for you as a formula. In the next video, we'll talk about nesting of the formula, though a part of it has already been covered, but let's take it on in our next video. Till then, it's goodbye from me, and keep sending me your comments and suggestions.